World Series. St. Louis win Game 3 as controversial call ends match. In the 1975 World Series, the Boston Red Sox begged for an interference call on Cincinnati's Ed Armbruster when he stepped in front of catcher Carlton Fisk, and never got it. Almost four decades later, an interference call was finally made, but once again the decision went against the Red Sox, in what seems destined to be remembered as one of the most disputed endings to a World Series game. Will Middlebrooks, the Red Sox third baseman, was called for obstructing Alan Crane as he rounded third base with two outs in the bottom of the ninth, and the St. Louis Cardinals won 5-4 in Game 3 of the World Series in front of 47,432 fans Saturday, the largest audience at the new Busch Stadium. The Cardinals lead the best of seven series 2-1. Game 4 is Sunday night, when Clay Buchholz is scheduled to start for the Red Sox against the Cardinals' Lance Lynn. With Yadier Molina at third and Crane at second, the Red Sox brought in the infield and John Jay hit a grounder to second base. Dustin Pedroia threw home to catcher Jarob Saltalamacchia, who tagged Molina. Saltalamacchia threw to third to get Craig, who was advancing on the throw home, but the ball got away. As Craig scrambled to get up and run home, Middlebrooks, sprawled on the infield dirt, lifted up his legs. Craig stumbled over home and ran home anyway, but he appeared to be tagged out on the second throw home to Saltalamacchia in the sequence. But the home plate umpire, Dana DeMuth, immediately ruled the obstruction and called Craig safe. As the Cardinals ran out of the dugout to celebrate, the Red Sox came out of theirs to argue, just as they did in 1975. But in both cases they lost the argument, and the game. The Cardinals scored twice in the first inning off Red Sox starter Jake Peavy, but were unable to do more damage against him when they had their chances, and Boston twice overcame two-run deficits to tie the score. Trailing by 2 in the eighth, the Red Sox put runners at second and third with one out against relief pitcher Carlos Martinez. St. Louis opted to walk David Ortiz intentionally to load the bases, then brought in the flame-throwing Trevor Rosenthal to face Daniel Mavic batting right-handed. Mavic hit a grounder to second baseman Colton Wong, who had come into the game in a double switch, but the relay throw from shortstop Pete Kosma to first was late. Jacoby Ellsbury, who had led off with a single, scored to make it 4-3. The next batter, Xander Bogaerts, hit a high bouncer up the middle that bounced off Kosma's glove and into center field as Shane Victorino, who had been hit by yet another pitch, trotted home with a tying run. Earlier, the Cardinals took a 4-2 lead in the bottom of the seventh, due in part to a small defensive lapse by the Red Sox. The roots of that play came in the top of that inning. With the score tied, Red Sox manager John Farrell pinch-hit Middlebrooks for Stephen Drew, the shortstop who is struggling offensively, but is still the top echelon defensive player. It was a gamble, because Farrell had to put Middlebrooks at third base in the bottom of the inning and move Bogaerts, the starting third baseman, to shortstop. Despite Drew's problems at the plate, he is a better defensive player than Bogaerts, and the difference soon became apparent.